Good morning, students. In earlier class, we have learned about two atriums and two ventricles. Let us discuss about main atriums and main ventricles. What are the main atriums? Main atriums to pump the blood into body parts. The main atrium, which is connected to ventricle, left ventricle, is known as aorta. What is that? Is aorta. Aorta is the main artery which carries the blood from left ventricle to all over the body. Left ventricle to all over the body. Here, what is that the main artery? The main aorta. What is that the main artery? Aorta is connected to left ventricle of the heart through the aortic valve. Here is also one valve is there in between the atrium and left atrium and left ventricle. Mitral valve is there. Mitral valve. Once if the atrium contracted, when the blood flows into ventricle, immediately the ventricle is also simultaneously should be gets the contraction. Through that contraction, the blood flows into another blood vessel which is called aorta. Aorta is the main artery. Aorta is the main artery to transport the blood all over the body parts except lung. Because this blood is carried from the lung only. This blood is carried from the lung along with the pulmonary vein, which is connected to left atrium. So the left atrium and lung has connection. The left atrium and lung has connection with pulmonary vein. What is the pulmonary vein? Which pulmonary means lung. Lung vein. Pulmonary means lung vein. Which the vein traveled from the lung to heart to supply the oxygenated blood, which is absorbed from the alveoli. That oxygenated blood once reached into the atrium, after the contraction of the atrium, when the blood reached into the ventricle, and when the contraction of the ventricle, the blood flows all over the body along with only main artery called aorta. What is that? Is main aorta. So in between the aorta and ventricle, left ventricle has another valve is there, another valve. So however, right left atrium and left ventricle, one valve is there, mitral valve, as well as left ventricle and aorta has one valve, because once the entire blood may enter into the aorta without get down once again after the contraction of left ventricle or at the relaxation phase, without getting back flow into the blood, blood immediately, the aorta is also should be closed along with one valve that is called aortic valve. What is it? Aortic valve. Here, aorta carries oxygenated blood from the left ventricle to all the body parts. So, what is meant by all the body parts? Here, except lung only. So, to the head region, to the neck region, and lung. Heart is also receiving blood along with aorta to do the different kind of activities, and as well as another lower parts, whatever may be there, innerly smooth parts or sensitive parts, and as well as external parts. Every part should be gets the oxygen and nutrients along with aorta. So these aorta should be connected with once again arteries. Minute vessels, arteries are there, and arteries connected to capillaries, and capillaries connected to veins. So on that way the blood should be flows. What kind of blood here? The left ventricle has oxygenated blood, because this blood is received from the lung along with pulmonary vein. So here what happened here, the ventricles are pumping the blood to all over the body parts except lung only, because this blood is received from the lung only. And another artery called pulmonary artery. What is another one? Is pulmonary artery. The pulmonary artery, which is connected to right atrium. The pulmonary vein is connected to left atrium, and the pulmonary artery is connected to right atrium. Don't forget that. Yeah. So here, the pulmonary artery carries deoxygenated blood from the body parts. Deoxygenated blood. The pulmonary artery carries deoxygenated blood from the body parts into the into the right atrium and right atrium to a right ventricle. So here we have to learn about pulmonary artery. The pulmonary artery brings blood from the body parts. Here what are there in the pulmonary artery? Again the pulmonary artery has superior in cava and inferior vena cava is there. Superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. So the pulmonary artery carries deoxygenated blood from the right ventricle to the lung. Okay, don't forget that. Once again, don't get any confusion here because both are similarly there. So while listening, you should be get some confusion. So left side of the atrium and ventricles are completed for us without having any confusion. And when we have observed the right side has one atrium and one ventricle is there. So the right atrium connected with pulmonary arteries. Right atrium connected with pulmonary arteries and right ventricle connected with pulmonary arteries. Here what happened here? These pulmonary arteries carries blood all over the body. What is meant by all over the body? Here this blood should be sent into the lung because it is a deoxygenated blood which is collected along with superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. So let us discuss about right atrium. Right atrium. The right atrium is connected to all over the body along with two blood vessels. Two blood vessels. What are the two blood vessels? One is superior vena cava, which is collected deoxygenated blood from the upper parts of the head, neck, etc. parts. And inferior vena cava collects the blood from the lower parts of the body, lower parts. So these two blood vessels, what are these two blood vessels? One is superior vena cava and another one is inferior vena cava. Both blood vessels are entered into a right atrium. Right atrium, right atrium, what is doing that? The right atrium only collecting the blood from the body parts, right atrium, along with the superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. What are superior and inferior vena cava? The superior vena cava which collect deoxygenated blood from the upper body parts, and inferior vena cava which collect deoxygenated blood from the lower parts of the body. So both are sent into right atrium. So immediately what should happen? The right atrium is also should make some contraction. So here less contraction, very few amount of the contraction, not more than the ventricle contraction, because once if the atriums are contracted with little force, the entire blood flows down into the ventricle, but the ventricle has to be make more contraction with high pressure, because it has to be reach all the body parts, peak parts, head region and leg region, tip of the leg region and tip of the hands, tip of the head region. So long distance it has to be transported, long distance, that's why it should be make more contraction. What happened here? While the right atrium contracting, right ventricle contracting, atrium and ventricle contacting, atrium should be send that blood into only right ventricle. Again, when the right ventricle contracted, it should be flows into lung from the right ventricle to what kind of blood this is? This is the deoxygenated blood. This deoxygenated blood send into all over the, okay, what is the area? The left atrium is connected to the left ventricle through mitral wall, and as well as the right atrium connected to the right ventricle through the tricuspid and bicuspid valves are there. Here the main, what is the area? The main artery aorta is there. The main artery aorta, we have learnt about that. What happened? The pulmonary artery or pulmonary veins, pulmonary artery and pulmonary veins, both are carrying blood from the body parts to heart and heart to body parts. What are the area? Pulmonary vein, which is connected to lung to left atrium, that is oxygenated blood, and as well as from atrium to right atrium to body parts, pulmonary artery carries deoxygenated blood into right atrium. Oxygenated blood carries from lung to left atrium to pulmonary vein. Yeah, when we have observed the heart outerly, outer lay, that is the four chambers. We have learnt about the four chambers. What are the four chambers? Two auricles and two ventricles. Two auricles and two ventricles. So when we have observed the outer side of however it is there, conical in shape or triangular in shape, outer portion covered with one thin membrane. So not one thin membrane, it is a double membrane. So in between the two membranes filled with pericardial fluid. So this membrane is known as pericardium. What are these two membranes? Outerly one membrane is directly attached to the heart and one membrane is outerly there. Heart outerly one membrane and one membrane attached to directly to the heart. Inner portion of the pericardium attached to the heart and outer membrane outerly there. So in between these two membranes filled with pericardial fluid. So this pericardial fluid protect from physical blows to the heart whenever we moved towards and whenever we bend, whenever the heart maybe gets any bruises or injuries, then this membrane or this fluid should be make some cushion like structures to protect the heart from the blows, physical blows. Here four chambers are there. This four chamber covered with this membrane. What is that? Is pericardial membrane. It is known as a pericardium. And innerly is also four chambers are separated with a membrane that is called septum. What is that? Is septum. So you can say atrioventricular septum. Arteries and ventricles are separated along with one septum, one membrane. So what is meant by septum? Septum means membrane. However, this membrane preventing by mixing of four chambers, the four chambers are separated with only this septum. What is this septum? Atrio, upper parts, ventricle, lower parts. So these atrium and ventricles are separating with one septum. That's why we can call that is atrioventricular septum. So let us discuss about the blood vessels. Yeah, it has the blood vessels. What are the blood vessels present in that? The blood vessels are heart. We have learned about the heart. It has blood vessels, arteries, veins, and arteries and veins and capillaries are the main blood vessels. Arteries, veins, and capillaries are the blood vessels. Among them, we have to learn about arteries. Arteries are the thick walled blood vessels than the ventricles and capillaries. Arteries are the thick walled blood vessels. So we know very well about, previously we learned about, where are connected to these arteries. These arteries are connected to ventricle, pulmonary artery and aorta. Pulmonary artery and the aorta, both are connected to ventricle to pump the, to carry the blood higher peaks. It has thick wall, because while contracting with high force to bear the pressure of the heart, it is lined with thick blood vessels. Mainly these arteries are carries the blood from heart to all the body parts. Maybe that is deoxygenated blood or oxygenated blood. That entire blood transport all over the body parts. That means long distance, maybe peak of the legs, peak of the hands, and peak of that, it has to be transported with high pressure. We learned the ventricle should be gets the high pressure than the auricles to get the strength, and the arteries lined with thick walls. Yeah, and the right atrium, the right side of the heart acts as a one pump, and as well as left side acts as another pump. We know very well about atrium. While pumping the atrium, when the blood reached into the left ventricle transport that blood all over the body. That is one pump, that should be declared as a one pump. And as well as right side, while the right atrium receiving blood from the body parts, and when they contracted, the contracted force, when the blood flows into the ventricle along with the left ventricle, right ventricle, the blood should be flows again into the lung to get the oxygenation. So here what happening? Left side doing one kind of contraction or pumping, and right side is also doing another kind of contraction. That's why human being example for the double pumping, double pump, our heart is a double pumping organ or double pumping pulsating organ. Before learning about this, I have to say about heart is a pulsating organ. What kind of pulsating organ? It pumps double times. So the blood is receiving once into the heart and hearts to body parts and again body parts to heart. That's why we can say our heart is double pumping organ. What kind of blood is pumping in that? First time oxygenated and another time deoxygenated, and once again both should be sent into the body parts, oxygenated and deoxygenated. So when we have observed the starting of the heartbeat in human being, that should be starts around 21st day of during the embryonic development. During the embryonic development, around the 21st day. What is meant by during the embryonic development? We know very well about ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. Those are present in the embryo. So while forming the organs in the body parts, at first time the heart is started the contraction or pumping or beating at 21st day of the embryonic development. So the human heart starts beating around 21st day during the embryonic development. Later we will discuss about blood circulation. Thank you.